What's up, Mavericks? This is Erica Sepala, writer and editor here at Merchant Maverick. Today, I'm going to show you how to connect your Square account to QuickBooks Online. If you receive business income from Square, this is definitely something you'll want to do. Similar to linking your bank accounts and credit cards, connecting your Square account to QuickBooks pulls in all of your transactions so you can keep track of everything all in one place. In order to do this, you're going to need QuickBooks Online, a Square account, and the login information for each. If you've connected other accounts before, like a checking account or a credit card, you're already familiar with the process. But even if you're new to it, it's all really easy. So let's get started. As you can see, I'm already logged into my QuickBooks Online account, and I'm on the main dashboard. Now, under Business Feed, we have Bank Transactions and Connect Accounts. Now, we can go in from there, but if your dashboard is set up a little differently, you can go over here in the side menu to Transactions, hover over that, click Bank Transactions, and you'll be able to connect from here. So we're going to click Connect Account. That'll bring us to this screen, which has 8 different accounts, none of which are Square. So you can click on Show More and scroll through all of the various accounts, or you can do the easy way and go to the search bar and just type in Square. So there's 2 different options here. Square Checking, if you have a Square Checking account, you can connect that to QuickBooks right here through Square Checking. We're just going to connect to our basic Square account. So we're going to go to this Connect to Square at squareup.com, and we're going to click on that. So as you can see from the progress bar at the top, we have 7 steps. Don't worry, they're all really quick and easy. The first step just kind of breaks down what happens when you connect your Square account to QuickBooks Online. You can connect your Square locations, track sales by product and customer details, and review and add everything in one spot. That sounds great and what we want to do, so we're going to click Get Started. This next screen just breaks down giving permission to QuickBooks Online to connect to your Square account. You can click on the Terms and Conditions and Privacy Statement if you want to review those. Also discloses that you can disconnect your account at any time. This all sounds great, so we're going to give our permission. Now, some of these steps may take a few seconds. Nothing takes a really long amount of time, so we're just going to wait and see what happens next. And what happens is that we get this Square login pop-up. Now, one thing worth noting is that if you have a pop-up blocker on your computer, QuickBooks will give you a notification letting you know that you need to disable that in order to move forward. We have already disabled that, so we got the Square login screen. So we are going to type in our Square email, or you may use a phone number, and that's okay too. And we're going to type in our password for our Square account. We're going to click sign in. Now, if you have not connected to that account on the device that you're using, it may require you to verify it with your phone number or some other method. So just be aware that that may be something you encounter. So once you have connected your Square account, you will need to select your business locations. If you have more than one location, you can choose 1, 2, however many you want to. We only have 1 active location for our business that is set up. So we're going to simply click on that location. Then we're going to go to select account. This QuickBooks Online account has just been set up for testing purposes. So we don't have a lot of accounts here. As you can see, we can add a new one if we want to, but we're just going to go with cash. Depending on where you want your transactions brought into, you can select whatever account you have set up. So we're going to select account and we're going to click next. This just breaks down how do you want to record your sales. You can record them individually. So that creates a sales receipt for every transaction. You can track your sales by customer or see product details in each sale. You can also record it as a summary, which doesn't allow you to track sales by customer, gives you your total product sales for the day, and just summarizes all transactions in one receipt. So down here, you have the option to choose which option you want. We are going to go with record sales individually and click next. Next, this is going to ask you how far back you want to go with your transactions. If you click on this dropdown, you can get started today. You can go back as far as the beginning of this month. You can go back to the beginning of the year, last year, or set something custom. Our Square account was set up for the purposes of this video, so we only have a handful of transactions. So we're just going to go with this year that starts January 1st, 2025, and click Finish. So now, as you can see, it is connecting to Square. And then it lets us know that Square is connected. our transactions will start coming into QuickBooks automatically, and we can get started by reviewing and categorizing recent transactions. So when we click check it out, it is going to take us to our transactions. And as you can see under transactions, app transactions, our Square account has been connected. Now, these are going to be where our transactions come in under this for review tab. But if you scroll down, you'll see that there's no transactions. That's because if you notice in the middle of the screen, it knows that it's bringing in our transactions, and it may take a while to bring them all in and to check back soon to see if some are ready. Can click refresh to update to see if it pulls them in. It has it. Now we have about 3 transactions in the Square account, and it usually takes just a few minutes. Now if you have multiple transactions, it may take a little bit longer. Go off and do something else and then come back and refresh, and it'll bring everything in pretty shortly. So we stepped away for a few minutes. We're going to refresh to update to see if this pulls in our transactions. And it did. So you can click on each individual transaction, and sometimes it'll pull this information in, like the customer name, John Smith, and kitchen cabinets, if this information is already in QuickBooks Online. If it isn't, you can just simply click on this. You can change the customer name, click the dropdown, choose a new customer, or add a new customer. Can also change the products or services if this is incorrect. Click down, scroll through what's already in here, or add new. We're going to just leave that the same and click done. So you can add a memo in here, anything that you would like to remember about this transaction. And when you're finished, you can simply click add. You scroll up, that'll move that from for review to reviewed. You'll want to go through all of your transactions from Square and make sure everything is accurate. Now, one other thing that you can do is up at the top of the screen, you'll see this Square and these 3 dots. You can click on these 3 dots. You can go in here and you can manage your locations, your deposit accounts, can add items or edit them, can add customers or edit them. And then you can go up here and you can edit the QuickBooks line items and the Square names to match with what is in your accounts. On this screen, you can also go down here in the bottom right corner and you can disconnect the Square account. Otherwise, that's how you connect your Square account to QuickBooks Online. Hope you enjoyed this video. Let us know in the comments if there's any other walkthroughs you want us to do. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you next time, Mavericks.